In your book, you're talking about companies who are painkillers versus vitamins. Could you talk a little bit more about that?
Sure. So there's kind of this religion about vitamins versus painkillers, that what we teach MBAs today, or what entrepreneurs hear when they go out and try and raise venture capital, is that they want to build a painkiller product. Right? We don't want to spend our time building vitamins, we want to build painkillers. Painkiller products are the kind of products that customers can tell you they need. Right? Stop my pain. They have quantifiable markets and they're eminently monetizable. Vitamins, on the other hand, that's the kind of product that people say, oh, you know what, I don't think I want to back that kind of project within an enterprise. Right? Your boss or your PM will say, oh, no, I don't really want, that's a vitamin feature. That's not something we need to build. Let's build the painkillers.
Right.
So a reason that a venture capitalist will say, you know what, we're going to pass on that idea, one of the reasons might be, you know, it just doesn't seem like something people really need. So that's the current way of thinking. I kind of challenge that way of thinking, because if you consider some of the products that we've been talking about that are very habit-forming, like Facebook and Twitter and Instagram and WhatsApp, these products didn't start out as painkillers, right? Nobody woke up 11 years ago in the middle of the night, 2 a.m, shouting, I wish I could update my status, right? That never happened before Facebook existed. So these products that become these painkillers over time, they start out as vitamins. They start out as nice-to-haves. And they're frequently dismissed. People say, oh, it's just a little toy, right? That's not going to have a big impact. Well, it turns out that by creating habits, by becoming these integral parts of people's day-to-day lives, they become painkillers as they form these habits. So today, if Mark Zuckerberg said, you know what, we're going to shut down Facebook, I've made enough money, I'm done, people would have conniption fits, right? They would have a big problem. All of a sudden, this product that was a toy and was just a vitamin has all of a sudden become a painkiller.
And how do I know if my idea is a painkiller or a vitamin that could become a painkiller?
Right, so it comes down to figuring out if you have these hooks. That if you have very little chance of forming a habit without having this hook built into your product, this four-step process that takes these pleasure-seeking behaviors and becomes these painkiller products.